Hey, what's going on, Dodgers Nation? D-Mac here. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at D-Mac underscore LA. Quick reminder for all things Dodger baseball all offseason long, be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, and if you want to see us post even more Dodgers content, smash that like button. Really helps out the channel. And as always, I want your takes down below in the comment section. Today's Dodgers Nation question of the day. What does your gut tell you? What do you think the percentage chances are right now that the Dodgers will end up signing Carlos Correa or Freddie Freeman? Drop a percentage for each. And also, if you had to pick between one or the other, Carlos Correa or Freddie Freeman, which one would you want the Dodgers to sign? Let me know down below. And for all latest Dodgers news, head over to DodgersNation.com. So just because the MLB is locked out and the Dodgers can't technically sign any players or communicate with any players, it doesn't mean that we won't have any rumors. And we've got a couple to dive into today, starting with Carlos Correa. So Jon Heyman was on his podcast, the Big Time Baseball Podcast, hosted by Tony Gwynn Jr., and they talked about some of the top remaining unsigned free agents. And when it came to Carlos Correa, he said it's pretty much two teams, the Astros and the Dodgers. Here's what Heyman had to say about Correa.
You know, I thought they would only go for Seager. If they didn't get Seager, they have Turner there. But, you know, with Seager not there now, so much extra money that they're not spending, you can't rule out the Dodgers for Correa. So those would be my two thoughts for Correa right now. It would be Houston or the Dodgers.
So first things first, let's break out that Dodgers rumor meter. And for this one, I'm going to actually give this a 2.5 Dodger dogs. Somewhere in between people are talking and serious smoke. But I do think we are getting closer to some serious smoke, to three Dodger dogs with Carlos Correa. Because one, the team that he was linked to, the team that most people expected him to sign with, the Detroit Tigers, they signed Javi Baez. So they won't be signing Carlos Correa. And many believe that he wanted to reunite with his old manager AJ Hinch in Detroit, but that's off the table. And then you talk about the New York Yankees. That's another big spender. They're a team that can afford a player like Carlos Correa, but one, they have those big shortstops coming up in Volpe and Peraza. Also, you didn't really hear too much about the Yankees when it came to Corey Seager at the end of the day when he signed with the Texas Rangers. And when you consider that the Yankees lineup, they need another plus left-handed bat, and they could have shifted Seager over to third, but they still didn't offer him a big contract. That kind of lets me know where the Yankees are as far as their offseason plans. And you also add the fact that Carlos Correa made those comments about Derek Jeter where he said that he didn't deserve any of his gold gloves. And you know that didn't sit well with fans in the Bronx. And also, Carlos Correa has also been a villain to Yankee fans even before he made those statements. Now, in my opinion, I think he's a good fit with the Boston Red Sox. Xander Bogaerts, he's not an elite shortstop defense. He can move over and change positions. Oh, and then who's the manager of the Boston Red Sox? It's Alex Cora. So I think he's a good fit with the Boston Red Sox. But when you talk about him with the Los Angeles Dodgers, the biggest conflict for me at this point is the fact that they already have Trey Turner under contract for one more season. Now, that to me is very interesting because if the Dodgers are seriously in pursuit of Carlos Correa, what does that tell you when it comes to Trey Turner? I mean, you read between the lines there and you read these tea leaves, and maybe Trey Turner has indicated to the Dodgers that he doesn't want to sign a big extension with LA. Is that a possibility? I know he does like it in Los Angeles, but there has been some talk that he wants to sign with a team on the East Coast where he's from. I think that's something that could be possible. And if you're the Dodgers, would you consider signing Carlos Correa for $300+ million and then you trade Trey Turner before the start of next season, or do you just have him at second base and you have Carlos Correa at shortstop? Infield wise, that would be one of the best infields in Major League Baseball. And then Trey Turner walks at the end of the deal. But I don't foresee a scenario where they give Carlos Correa the bag and Trey Turner the bag and you shift Carlos Correa over to third base. Because one, Carlos Correa is a Platinum Glove Award-winning infielder. He is one of the best defensive shortstops in all of Major League Baseball. Yes, he's a big dude at 6'4", and generally you see those guys slide over, kind of like Cal Ripken Jr., and like you're going to see with Corey Corey Seager, hopefully soon if you're the Texas Rangers. But I think Carlos Correa would want to stay at that shortstop position. It's a premium position. It's a glamour position. It increases your chances of being in the Hall of Fame almost double. So if I'm Carlos Correa, I'm saying, hey, I want to be the long-term solution at shortstop. But then, hey, if you're the Dodgers, you say, hey, look, you've had some back issues. Maybe if you shift over to third base, you reduce your injury risks. But I think he'll be a shortstop for at least the next 3 or 4 years. I don't foresee him making that move any sooner than that. So to me, it's either Carlos Correa or Trey Turner. I don't think they will sign them both. And you also consider the fact that the Astros, they significantly lowballed Carlos Correa, offering him a 5-year, $160 million deal. Are they really going to be willing to double that in money and in years just in the matter of a few months? What would make them change their tune on Carlos Correa so much that they would double their offer? I just don't know if that's a possibility. So I think the Dodgers are definitely in the mix, and I'm not necessarily all in on this move or advocating it, but I'm just trying to let you know what the Dodgers' thought process could be at the moment, because you do need a premium shortstop. And look, it's undeniable how good of a player Carlos Correa is. The only question is, would the fan base accept him? Based on the polling that I've done on some of the stuff I've thrown out on Twitter, the answer is no by a large majority. And I think the big risk if you're the Dodgers is, let's say you make this signing and it doesn't work out. Let's say he's injury prone, he's not productive. Dodger fans will never forgive Andrew Friedman and this organization if it doesn't work out. But if they sign him, he's a great player, he's a perennial all-star, he leads the Dodgers to a World Series championship, and he comes in and he's contrite and he's genuine with his apology about what happened in 2017. Hey, I think there is a chance that the Dodgers fans could ultimately embrace him in time. It wouldn't happen overnight, but I do think if you look at the fan base, you kind of gauge what people are saying right now, there are some Dodger fans that are very interested in potentially making this signing, and you see some more and more warming up. And then there's some fans that are saying, no, never, not a chance. So it's really interesting. Would the Dodgers sign another polarizing player for the second consecutive offseason? That's the big question. And another thing to consider, too, is the fact that this lockout could have actually helped the Dodgers, because it gives them more time to see, do they really want to invest $300-plus million in a Carlos Correa? Do they really want to invest $180 million in Freddie Freeman? Because they were trying to re-sign Corey Seager. They did offer him a large sum of money, north of $275 million to $300 million. They did want to bring back Max Scherzer. So is this money burning a hole in the Dodgers' pockets? Do they see this as another opportunity to flex their financial muscle, because organizations like the Yankees aren't the same when it comes to spending? They have been cheaper in recent years. The Red Sox, I mean, the Dodgers are a team that when it comes to financial resources, they're second to none, and there's only a handful of franchises that can afford a player like Carlos Correa. So really, his options are somewhat limited when you consider the kind of money that he's after. You know he wants to get paid more than Corey Seager. Seager definitely set the market, as well as Lindor last season, and you know that Correa is going to get a big-time payday. You know it's going to be north of $300 million, and I do think, hey, if the Dodgers want him and he wants to be a Dodger, that's a deal that could be made, and I think a lot of it hinges on the future of Trey Turner. So I think that is the question, because of course we all say, oh, we want to re-sign Trey Turner. We want to extend Trey Turner, but Trey Turner also has to want to commit long-term to the Dodgers, and there's no indications that he wants to do that as of yet. And I do think that the Dodgers' interest in Carlos Correa is very telling. I think it's very interesting as far as the Dodgers' future with Trey. So that's just kind of where we're at, and I think that you got Jon Heyman, a guy that's very plugged in. He's Scott Boras's mouthpiece, and you know that, hey, anytime you see the Dodgers' names linked with these players, at some point it happens. We saw it happen with Mookie Betts. We saw it happen with Trevor Bauer. So you definitely have to consider things like this very seriously. But let me know down below in the comments section, what percentage chance do you think the Dodgers will ultimately end up signing Carlos Correa? And also, do you think the Dodgers fans will ever accept him? Let's say he has a great first couple years. Will they warm up to him? Will they never warm up to him? And also, if you had to pick between Carlos Correa and Freddie Freeman, who would you rather the Dodgers sign? Let me know down below in the comments section. My name is Doug McCain. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram at DMAC_LA. For all things Dodger baseball, be sure to hit that subscribe button, hit that notification bell, and if you want to see us post even more Dodgers content, smash that like button. For all latest Dodgers Nation merch, head over to gearup.la. Download the new Dodgers Nation app for my Android and iPhone users. For latest Dodgers news, head over to DodgersNation.com. MLBInsider.com. Until next time, think blue, bleed blue, and I'm out.